$137 million racism settlement against Tesla. Employee gets the settlement. It gets knocked down to $3 million. I will explain how this injustice happened. Let's put up his picture for a mask. Tesla is paying out again over their alleged racial abuse against black employees. We previously reported on a lawsuit where the automaker paid $1 million to another ex-Tesla employee. Now, Owen Diaz, former employee and subject of a recent lawsuit, just got his $137 million settlement cut to $3 million. I'm going to explain how this is even possible. It was just 18 months ago that former Tesla worker, Owen Diaz, won a massive $137 million verdict after a jury found that he had endured a brutal racist work environment at the company. Brutal is what they discovered. Months later, a judge decided to reduce the payout to $15 million. Okay, that's your first reduction. Diaz opted to reject that sum, and the case was retried this year. So what is this about? How can a judge come in and just say, ah, I don't like that number, I'm going to decrease it? Well, we call it tort reform in law school. However, tort reform is basically a word that says, you know, business owners, individuals who want to protect their liabilities, Fortune 500 companies, et cetera, they lobby. They lobby certain organizations that will then lobby lawmakers and judges, elected judges in particular, and lawmakers to transform the law, giving judges these particular powers, all right? And then some states literally have a cap on what the jury can award, but the jury is unaware of this cap, so they can make a ruling, and then the judge can come in under tort law or tort reform and change it. Yep, that's how powerful companies are. There's more. Speaking to the Daily Beast, Diaz expressed frustration, as any of us would, with the makeup of the jury, talking about the second time, all right? So he expressed issue with the makeup of the jury, which he alleged was not made up of peers, but rather by whites and idiots. Many of the jurors seemed to have comfortable financial lives, he said, meaning that they did not realize what it's like to live paycheck to paycheck, nor did they comprehend the historical significance of what was said and what was done at Tesla. Diaz said he plans to appeal the verdict since justice still has not been served. So there is an appellate process for actions like this when it is done through judicial behavior or judicial action. Now, this is an ironic situation. You have a jury that looked at the evidence. They said, whoa, this is aggressive. This is egregious. And we're going to allocate punitive here, meaning we want to make sure that we send a clear message to any other company that would engage in this kind of activity. The fact that the settlement was so high is indicative of the actual suffering experienced by the employee. So understand, the jury are the fact finders in the case. They have all the information, we do not. They saw this information and they said, this is egregious, and made the ruling. Diaz has no regrets in rejecting the original $15 million proposal by the judge, because he didn't believe that figure would have forced the company to make any meaningful changes, okay? It's just so rampant inside of the company, he says. It's to the point where it just has to stop, he alleged. He added that he had hoped the jury would see through Tesla's BS and help a lot of African Americans be able to work and not to have to keep going through the things that they're going through. In cases of systemic harassment, it's not like we can take these CEOs to jail. He argued money is the most impactful way they can be punished, and he's completely correct. Let's put up the tweet. Isn't this interesting? Meanwhile, Tesla CEO Elon Musk chimed in and said, if we had been allowed to introduce new evidence, the verdict would have been zero. The jury did the best they could with the information they had. I respect the decision. Diaz argued that the evidence in his case was clear As he told the Daily Beast in 2021, his supervisors at Tesla allegedly mocked him with racist imagery and slurs. I had supervisors telling me, N-word, hurry up, and push the button. N-word, push these batteries out of the elevator. And they were also telling me, N-word, N-words aren't ish, okay? Some elements of the broken culture were left unaddressed because of Tesla's use of arbitration agreements, he claimed, which can limit employees' ability to file lawsuits. Diaz said he remains committed to reforming the automaker. Hopefully, if I can't accomplish it, the next person who files a lawsuit will be able to do so. Lawsuits, I guarantee you, are still going to come from that company. Multiple have been settled. Some are being litigated. Elon Musk, obviously, not responsive to the culture, still saying, well, if we would have introduced other evidence, he would have received nothing. I'm glad this is actually under appeal because I think the appeal is going to bring out some more, not only coverage of what's happening, but other people who are going to stand up from that company. AB, thoughts?
So first and foremost, it's unfortunate that y'all South African CEO is more concerned about the jury verdict, right, being what it is, as opposed to the fact that there's a culture of racism in his company. So let's start there. Mr. You know, free speech and constitutional thumping, so and so on Twitter. So let's start with that piece. The second part I want to say is that Mr. Diaz is absolutely right in that we go for punitive damages for these corporations because it is almost the only way for them to be punished because they aren't actual people or you can't take the actual people to jail, right? So we punish the corporation by making them pay. And so I do think a settlement, some people would be like, oh, you're just trying to get a bunch of money. But I think the settlement is more than about the money and to say stop the culture at the end of the day, or it's going to cost you in your pockets. And one thing successful rich people don't like is for you to play with their pockets, right? And the other issue I want to address is this issue of a jury of our peers. This is such a vague term that we don't understand. What does it mean to have a jury of your peers? And we see this challenge every time, especially when Black people are there trying to get justice. The jury makeup is never conducive, right, to that particular person's situation. And so we need to do better in legislating on what, like, changing the tone and the language of what a jury of your peers look like, because this is just unfair. And this is how you prevent justice from happening.
Yeah, there you go.